Now I'm going to talk about the games. This is going to be very controversial. But to be honest, I don't have that many Sega Genesis games to, you know, I don't have that many. Because it's a Christmas present and I've had it for about 4 months, so. But here are some of the games I own. And of course, you got Sonic the Hedgehog. This was the most famous game on the Genesis. Yeah, I get it. Like, characters move fast, sprites move fast, and when Sega came up with the term blast processing, they compared this game to Super Mario Kart, and saying that anything on the Super Nintendo was slow compared to any game on the Sega Genesis, which is pretty much what it is. There's also a lot of great sports titles you can buy, like here's one, NHL 95. That tab does nothing. That just shows you that's an EA product. But this is my favorite sports game on the Genesis that I have so far. Mario Lemieux Hockey. Yeah, it's very common to find these in their original case because it's like a CD and DVD case. Manual game. Yeah. And then there's NHLPA Hockey 93. I played this one a lot, so limited edition version. Same manual game. Like, I really liked how they did their boxing. So, how they did the casing. This is a later game, because it had the red label that says Genesis on it. This is when the Model 2 came out. Oh, look at that. The first rating system, the Video Game Rating Council, rated this GA, General Audiences, which in ESRB terms is rated E for everyone. Just so you know, the Video Game Rating Council isn't around anymore because the ESRB took them out of business. Yeah. So this is one of my favorite games, World Championship Soccer 2. But, yeah, there are tons of great games for the Sega Genesis, like Mortal Kombat, Streets of Rage, Street Fighter 2, Golden Axe. I mean, some of the greatest arcade titles you can go get out there. There's also Virtua Racing. Man, there's a lot of games. There's the original John Madden Football. Oh, there's a lot of games. So many games. It's hard to choose which one is the best. I can't. Well, now I'm going to talk about the PlayStation 2 games. Now, the PlayStation 2 had games that spanned every genre. No matter what you were into, there was a game on the PlayStation 2 that fit your expectations. Of course, I got my all-time favorite sports game here, NHL 06. Yeah, my YouTube account name doesn't lie. Yeah, I mainly collect sports games and racing games because those are some of my favorites, and it's pretty much because of the ESRB giving the ratings and stuff like that. Got Midnight Club 3 Dub Edition Remix, that's the NHL 2K5. This is a very in-depth sports game. If you don't have it, go buy it. It's real dirt cheap nowadays, and it's the last NHL 2K game that was good. NHL 2K9 came close, but no. Also, NHL 2K3. This is back when Sega made them. How awesome is that? Speak of irony, by the way, I'm comparing two systems. NHL 2003, NCAA Football 2004, NHL 2004. I got a golf game here, Tiger Woods PGA Tour 2004. I play that during my leisure time. Like, there's just a bunch of sports games that I've been naming off the bat. Speaking of bat, MLB 07 The Show. The Accursed NHL 07, NHL 2002, Madden NFL 2005, which is my favorite Madden game. NHL Faceoff 2003. That's my writing, because it didn't come in a case. It came with a sleeve that you get from GameStop. That's where I bought the game. Let's see. Madden NFL 2001. The first Midnight Club Street Racing. Gran Turismo 3. This is a very good game. Rally Racing has never been better. NHL 2K6 also came in a sleeve. NHL 08 came in a sleeve. NHL 2K9 came in a sleeve. You get the idea. There's also PlayStation 1 games that'll play, because it's also a PlayStation 1. There are a bunch of games here. Just rattling them off. Yeah, I know I've got a lot of NHL games, and I'm a hockey freak, so. And then I've got some racing games like NASCAR 99. That was a good game. NCAA Football 99, except for the PlayStation 1's graphics, it was really crude. We just got a bunch of games here. NFL 2000, NCAA Football 2000. Yeah, this is kind of getting boring for me, so I know how you feel. Madden NFL 2002, which is pretty much the last Madden game on the PlayStation 1. The first two Gran Turismo games, Gran Turismo 1, Gran Turismo 2. So this is in the budget version, the greatest hits version. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. But all those games are just, they're amazing. Oh, wait. But of course, my all-time favorite racing game, Gran Turismo 4. And when you stack all that up, you've got a great selection of games, and even the games I don't have that I played before, they're awesome. There's Enthusia Professional Racing, there's Metal Gear Solid. Oh man, there's so many great games, I can't really name them off the bat. So in game selection, I gotta give this to the PlayStation 2. Tons more games than the Sega Genesis. So yeah. Alright, now I know, casing is a minor complaint, but isn't it nice to have something to put your game in? But this is very hard comparing these two systems together when it comes to casing. There's a jewel case for the PlayStation 2 and jewel case for the Sega Genesis. But of course, this is the first. Sega was the first to manufacture this kind of thing. They were the first to manufacture these jewel cases for their games, starting with the Sega Master System, which was the predecessor to the Sega Genesis. I mean, right there, this is what you would see on a modern day format. You've got your manual here. This, let's see. So you got your cheap manual. Yeah, they just ran out of money at this point. And there's your game right there. Although, what I like with the cartridge design, I want to talk about that later, is they're more durable than a disc, a CD or DVD format. I'll talk about that later. Now, the PlayStation 2's jewel cases. PlayStation 2 has slim jewel cases because all there is a CD or DVD in there. And it's pretty much the same thing. Manual, game. And this is a PlayStation exclusive because it actually shows you right there. That's the Sony Computer Entertainment logo. And some of these also came with these. Like, they came in. Some of the manuals came with catalogs or registration stuff. I still haven't mailed this yet. And I actually did fill this out when I was like 11. Like, want to get more out of your PlayStation 2? Yes, I do. I'm getting kind of tired of the same old games. And then you actually can mail this. I don't know if I can mail that anymore, but. Oh well. But still, what's the Sega Genesis? Cases didn't have was a memory card holder. I guess that was because the cartridge is a battery backup for some games. But, but still, I gotta give the winner to the Sega Genesis casing because it pioneered what we see today. Just think that. Back then, we had these jewel cases, and today we still have them. See, that's how famous they were.